Hello and welcome back to another video. My name is Mike Davies, and in today's tutorial, I'll be showing you how to emulate the clarity slider found in premium software such as Adobe Photoshop, Affinity Photo, Lightroom, etc. I'll be using GIMP version 2.10.28, which is the latest version of GIMP at the time of this tutorial. Before I get into that, don't forget to check out my website at daviesmediadesign.com. As always, I have tons of video tutorials on here, as well as free software help articles, so definitely check that out. You can enroll in my GIMP 2.10 Masterclass from Beginner to Pro Photo Editing on Udemy, and you can get access to more content with a premium membership, and I'll include a link to this as well as all the relevant links from this tutorial in the description of the video. I'll be using a couple of free plugins for this tutorial. One is from Gimmick. You guys have probably heard of it by now. You can get it at gimmick.eu. Just click the download button there. And the second plugin is one that was created for this channel by Kevin Thornton. You can get it exclusively from my website, and I will include a link to this in the description. All right, so if you've ever edited a photo in premium software, you've probably come across the clarity slider. So here I am inside of Affinity Photo. What this slider does is it just adds clarity, or it adds detail to certain areas of the photo. And what I've done here is I've created a layer and just sort of circled the areas that are being affected most by this slider or by this setting. So it's a lot of the mountain details here, some over here at the very top. None of the highlights are affected over here, but over here, some parts of the road, and there are some minor effects to these portions of the image. Basically, what the clarity slider does in a nutshell is it adds local contrast to the midtones of the image. There are probably some other factors that go into the clarity slider for the premium software versions of this. However, that's basically what's happening. So what we need to do in GIMP is we need to isolate the midtones and we need to add local contrast to those midtones. So let's get started with creating this effect in GIMP. Here I am in GIMP 2.10.28. What I'll do first is open up my image. So I'll go to File, in my case, Open Recent. And I'm gonna open the JPEG version of this photo, which I'll make available exclusively on my website. So this is the same photo I was using in Affinity Photo. So there are basically two main steps to this. The first is going to be to apply local contrast using Gimmick. So with this layer selected, I'm gonna go to Filters, Gimmick QT. It should show up here if you have it installed correctly. And if I type in the search bar local contrast, you're gonna see under the detail section, we have an effect here called Simple Local Contrast. And as you can see, it's just adding a ton of contrast throughout the image. So I really like this setting, and I like it with all the default settings here. The main thing is just make sure the channels is set to luminance only. That way it only affects the luminance of the image and not the color. So that'll really just keep a lot of color noise out of the image. And also under output mode, make sure this is set to new layer. That way it's going to put the final result on a new layer over here in the layers panel. So I'm gonna click OK to apply this effect. So now up top here, you can see we have the new layer and it's got that local contrast filter applied to it. So really it's just creating a very contrasty image. However, the issue right now is that the contrast is being applied throughout the entire image and not just localized to the midtones. So that brings us to the next step, which is going to be using that Luminosity plugin. And you can do Luminosity masks manually in GIMP. I actually have an entire tutorial dedicated to showing you how to do that. However, with this simple plugin, which does work with the latest version of GIMP, you can basically just click a button and you can get Luminosity masks for all levels of the image. So to use this, we're gonna come up top here to the top layer. And let's just rename this Local Contrast. Hit the Enter key. So on our local contrast layer, next we're gonna go to Filters, Generic, and here you'll see it says Luminosity Mask Setup. That article I pointed out towards the beginning of the tutorial does show you how to download and install this in your GIMP. So I'll click on this option. And what's gonna happen now is it's going to set up the luminosity masks. All right, once that plugin is done doing its thing, we're gonna end up with a bunch of new layers here, and they're gonna be separated into different groups or organized into different groups. So what you have here is you have luminosity masks for the various luminosity parts of the image. So here you have your lights, and it's going to be a wider range of lighter pixels in your image. So like the sky and some of the light coming off from the sky. And then as you go up, you've got the double L, which is basically just a narrower version of the lights or just the lighter parts of the image. And then the triple L is going to be the very lightest parts of your image. So we don't need to use lights for this. So you can actually just delete that layer group. And what we're just going to be focusing on is the midtones here. So the same thing applies. You've got a wider range of midtones at the bottom, and then you've got a more narrow range of midtones at the top. And so we're just going to delete the darks layer group. And actually, we're also going to delete the mids layer group. So we're deleting all of the layer groups that were created by that plugin, and we're back to basically where we were before the plugin ran. The only difference is if I come over to channels, now you'll see we have all of the luminosity masks here saved to our channels. So we're going to be putting those to use. So all you need to do here is come over to the local contrast layer, right click, and go to add layer mask. And under initialize layer mask 2, we're going to choose channel. And I found that the triple M layer worked the best for emulating the clarity effect. But you can click on the drop down here and you can go with any of the midtone options, really, depending on what you're going for. You can even try out the other luminosity levels there if you want. But I'll go with the triple M option and click add. So you'll see that's going to limit the local contrast effect just to the midtones of the image. So if I come over here and hide this, there's a before, there's an after. So the main difference here with this effect is that you are going to get probably a bit more contrast going on in this part of the image. Whereas inside of a program like Affinity Photo, let me just hide this, you really had a more subtle effect over here. But this method does come with a level of flexibility that you won't find in premium software with that simple slider. Because basically what you can do here is you can duplicate this layer. And right now we have the triple M luminosity mask on here. Let's right click and go to delete layer mask, right click, add layer mask. And we're going to change this using the mouse wheel to double M and click add. And so now what you're doing is you're compounding the layers. So if you see here, this is just with the triple M layer. So let's rename that triple M so we know. And then when we unhide the double M layer, it's bringing in a bit more contrast into different areas of the image. So we'll just change that to double M. So basically you can introduce more contrast to more midtones of the image if you want to. So let's duplicate this and do this one more time. So delete layer mask. And you can just click the layer mask icon here and go with M. So now we have it in all of the midtones. Let me change this to M. So basically we're just layering the local contrast to this until we're happy with it. And then one last thing we can do to customize this further is we can add a layer group. So let's rename this midtones, hit the enter key, and we're going to click and drag all of these into the layer group. And the reason I want to do this is now I can click on the layer group itself, and I can add a layer mask to this. And let's just go with white full opacity and click add. So now what I can do is with my paintbrush tool selected, and I have this set to a softer brush, so it's around 32 right now, and I'll reset my colors to black and white. So what I can do with this is with the color black, I can paint on the layer mask and just paint out any areas that I don't want to have that contrast added to it. So I can paint out all this if I wanted to, maybe paint out some of this stuff here. And that just allows us to have more control. So here's a before, here's an after. So now it looks very similar to what you would see in a premium program like Affinity Photo. Plus you have a bit more flexibility. All right, so that's it for this tutorial. Hopefully you liked it. If you did, don't forget to like this video, subscribe to my channel, and click the bell icon to be notified each time I have a brand new tutorial. You can check out any of the links to my resources in the description of the video. But thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.